My name is Braja Swain, working as an agriculture economist in ILRI India. I'm based in Odisha, it's an Indian, it's an Eastern Indian state. Here, I am going to speak how the story, how I have influenced the decision makers to invest on feed and fodder. Like generally in India, I don't know about the world, most of the veterinary, they don't give any importance to feed and fodder. They just discuss about the vaccine or health or any others. They just live in the feed and fodder. But see, the feed and fodder consists of more than 70% of the livestock rearing. Let me tell my background. I come from a farming background. We had around 4 cattle and 5 acres of land. When I was in and student, I used to support my parents for farming. I know everything I can do. And I remember that when I was in 9th standard, my father was a teacher and my mother was a housewife. My father didn't get salary for 9 months due to their crisis in government, financial crisis. And in that time, we had only the dairy farmer, the only option for us to support our education. What my mother did, he used to process the milk and sell the cheese in the market. And that, I remember in that time, we used to earn around more than $2. And due to this dairy farming, they could always support us for our education. And that time, my father also supported my parents, my mother, to selling milk and buying the feed. And in that time, I realized that livestock does matter. It has a more importance for improving the livelihood. And I thought, okay, in future if I get chance, I definitely I'll work on the livestock sector. Fortunately, when I was doing my PhD in agriculture economics, I joined in ILRI, and that from that time, but I must say here, initially period I was not liking ILRI, the work, because always they are sending to field to collect primary data or to discuss with the farmers. And I had a notion during my PhD, everybody said, oh, you have to publish in international journals, you should have a high impact paper. So I had a notion, if I work in an international organization, I will get more research papers, so I can get more exposure. I didn't thought about though there is just more scope in work in the field. In the due course of time, I have come across different farmers, like different regions, like not in India, Bangladesh, and also in Africa. That has opened my eye. And I remember one woman farmer, she's very hardworking. That has inspired me. And that has changed my mind that the way of doing research for publication only. What I have done from, and also, I've seen that woman also, he is very hardworking, doing different kind of farming like fishing, dairying, and also other activity to support their children education. And she inspired me. I've seen she inspired me to work more hard in the rural area to support the poor farmers, poor dairy farmers who doesn't have knowledge on better livestock management. And from that period, I thought it can happen only the good partnership, not only working in the like in the office or I'm talking in one person. It can happen only the partnership. From that point of time, me and my colleagues have started hard working to influence, to have to build a relation with the like different stakeholders, particularly government institutions like a director of veterinary or any other departments. And in due course of time, we have organized one workshop to present our research outcome, what we have done in the initial period, and where the government, there are some agriculture minister, chief secretary of that department, also they attend that meeting. And after 2 days of meeting, the chief secretary, they called me and asked us, can you develop a proposal to expand this activity to other part of the state? Then it was the proudest moment for me, because the outcome, the research or the field activity, what we have done, the, now the government is realizing that this has done the good work. And they have decided to fund us around $1 million. And for a state government, it's the first for the ILRI to work with the state government and getting the fund from ILRI, from the state government. And particular, I remember that period, the minister, they told us, we like the ILRI team of that in India, the way they work with the community of the dairy farmer. So what we have done, that project is going on, that's in the, like a feed and fodder, and it's in third year. And I must say here that during this 2 years, we have influenced the government to use, to include our this technology, like what we have done, feed and fodder, like new variety of fodder or a new feeding technology in their state plant scheme. I must say here that the Indian government, they have some different schemes and they give subsidies for to disseminate this technology. And the government has targeted, like yesterday, Michael was asking me that, can you go for a scale like 1 million or 1 crore? I must say that the government has agreed to disseminate this technology to more than 1 million of farmers in Odisha, and in a few course of time, like within 5 years. And I must say that this is, I have done something different. And I feel proud that working in ILRI, and ILRI has helped me to do the something and what I thought during my school period. And I must say here that I feel happy and I feel proud that I have done something my rural way for my rural farmers. And I love to work in the field, not as the office scientist, what I had a notion during my PhD. And by only for doing the research for publication may not help the farmers who are waiting for us to get a new technology. Thank you.
Thank you so much. There are two stories.